there, pretty people, and welcome back to Such Pretty. Today, Kaylee is here, and we are going to be doing the best friend tag. So, yeah.
We're going to start.
We're going to start.
Right now.
We're going to do it.
You're going to do it.
We're going to do the thing. What is your best friend's biggest fear?
So, I'm supposed to answer about you, and are you going to answer about me? Is that where we're going to do it?
Yeah.
Okay, I think your biggest fear is spiders.
Yes, my biggest fear is spiders. I have a severe fear of spiders. I have really, really bad arachnophobia to the point where I can't even look at photos of it. Please don't send photos. Please don't send photos. Like, even...
She can't even handle, like, Harry Potter with the giant CGI spider in the roller skates.
That's awful. I get that the whole scene is supposed to be about fear, but no, I can't do it. So, for Kaylee, her fear is passports.
I'm super afraid of passports. You know, like, when I was a kid and watched Maury and they'd bring on those people who had, like, really weird fears, like balloons or cotton or pickles or...
Pickles.
Like, really weird things. I am afraid of passports. I don't have one, and I used to work in the medical field where I would have to take identification from people, and very, very rarely, maybe 5 times in my entire career there, I had to scan a passport, and I couldn't even hold them. I just don't like passports.
One of those fears, man.
It's one of those things that make no sense. I just do not like passports. Oh, that was a good one. It's the same. Does your best friend have any strange phobias? Okay. Does your best friend have any nicknames? And I know that that Sasha's mom calls her Sashi.
Yes.
So that's one that I know of hers.
Kaylee, I think your dad calls you Pumpkin.
Yeah.
Yeah, got one.
My mom calls me Cece.
That's cute.
Yeah, she's called me Cece since I was a kid. So.
Cece Babcock.
She used to actually call me CCBB because that's my initials.
Mm-hmm.
She actually started with Kaylee Bo Bailey. And then it just started, then it was like Kaylee, and then it was like CCBB, and then it was Cece, and now she just sometimes calls me Cece.
That's cute.
Yeah.
That's really cute. What is it like being best friends with someone who is obsessed with YouTube? We're both on YouTube. Like, what? What is your favorite memory? Like this isn't like about your best friend, but like
in
us as best friends, like what is our favorite memory?
Our favorite memory together?
Yes. Like a favorite memory you have of us together. Yes.
Okay, well, I think it's always concerts and it's hard to pick like which one. But my favorite memory was probably we went to go see Fall Out Boy the day after Thanksgiving in Denver, and so the day of Thanksgiving we got there because we always wait like
24 hours in line,
36 some odd hours in line. So we got there on Thanksgiving the day before the concert, and it was at a college campus, and it was open, and the arena was an ice arena, and they would cover it in boards.
We went and explored. and we went
inside
the Magnus Arena
and onto the ice in Denver, like in the middle of the night. Like, there's nobody, like, I mean, it was dark outside, and we slept on a mattress, an air mattress, and it was -3 degrees, and it snowed, and we slept outside, and it was...
All for Fall Out Boy. My favorite memory would be, there was a time in like 2008 where we followed Cobra Starship on tour. We weren't groupies, we were friends. because she's actually really good friends with Gabe. So we followed them from like, we had gone to Denver to see Panic at the Disco, and then right after that show, we were gonna drive all the way to Kansas City, from Denver to Kansas City, to catch the next Cobra show.
And then drive back the next night to see Cobra in Denver the next night.
Yes. And then drive from Denver to Salt Lake City to see Cobra there.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, my most favorite memory, like, from that whole thing, like, that that whole trip was is a really favorite memory of mine, but one of my favorite parts is when we were driving through Kansas City in the middle of the night. It's like 3 a.m.
We hadn't slept in like 17 days.
Yeah, we hadn't slept. And we see like those big giant like windmills.
And they have the windmills
that make energy.
Yeah, the energy windmills. And
they look so freaky in the dark.
They blink these red lights, and there were like a ton of hundreds of them. And Kansas is flat as shit, so like, oops, whatever.
Yeah.
Kansas is flat as crap, so you could see it
them from miles away.
Like, I swear we were looking at them for 30 minutes. Like, yes. What are those?
Yeah.
It was
they
so
were pretty
scary.
Creepy. And then, because we're so damn tired, we hit something. I think we hit some sort of animal, and we're so tired and driving, and we shouldn't be driving, but we're tired and we're driving, and we're like, did we just hit a wolverine?
That was the first thing that popped in my mind, was that it was a wolverine that we hit, and I don't even know why.
I don't even think there's wolverines in Kansas.
I've never even seen a wolverine. I don't know.
And so then we made jokes about it being like wolverine jerky.
Yeah.
Because we were eating jerky too.
Yeah, like protein. If you ever like follow a band on tour and you don't have a lot of money to buy a lot of food to put in your body,
eat a
lot of beef jerky.
Yes, it'll keep you going. A lot of beef jerky. So yeah, that's my favorite memory.
Any inside jokes? We just described one.
We described an inside joke?
Oh, here's one. No, well, yeah, the wolverine jerky.
Oh, yeah. But, I mean, that's part of the memory. We could still...
Let's think of another inside joke that we have. Oh, do you want to go to Subway after this?
Yes! Okay. Okay. Favorite inside joke. There's a place in our hometown where we would always go and eat sushi. And for a while, like several years ago, probably in, like, 2007, 2008, we would go and eat sushi every Friday.
Mm-hmm. We had a standing room reservation. We were always
yes,
there.
Yes, yes.
But this place, we were in a landlocked state. We were in Colorado, and sushi is hard to come by, hard to find, and very expensive.
Yes.
So the portions are pretty small.
Yeah, you'd probably get like 4-8 pieces.
Yeah.
No, not even 8, like
yeah,
6.
Yeah, 6 pieces, and it was pretty spendy. It's pretty spendy. It still is, and I don't know if you guys know, but we're both a whole lot of women, and we need more than just that sushi. So one day, we were eating, and we always would just eat on Fridays, just eat our one roll of sushi and get our drinks and whatever, and go home. But we were both so still hungry.
Yeah, we were still really hungry afterwards.
And like, neither of us really wanted to say anything about, like, how hungry we were. And then, like, we're sitting there eating, and Sasha's finally just like,
do you want to get Subway after this?
I was like, yes, so much. That's all I want to do.
Yes. So now it's become our thing where, like, it doesn't matter what we're doing.
We are going to go get Subway after.
Yeah. I'll be like, hey, do you want to get Subway after this? And there's several times where we have gone
just
and got
gone
Subway afterwards.
Mm-hmm.
So do you want to get Subway after this?
Yeah, we're going to go get some Subway
we're gonna
after
get some
this.
Subway. But yeah, that's definitely one of our most favorite, and one we still frequently use,
yeah,
like, all the time.
It's hard to think about, because I know that we have more that we use, like, in conversation and whatever, but...
Yeah, the Subway
probably
after this.
Do you want to talk about Neruda eyeliner? Or no?
The Neruda eyeliner. Okay, yeah, we have to talk about the Neruda eyeliner.
Okay,
so we absolutely love Kat Von D.
So much.
And she... From photos and stuff that we've seen, she has an absolutely gorgeous liquid white eyeliner called Neruda. Unfortunately, we don't have the money to just spend on a lot of cosmetics.
So we already have some white eyeliners.
Yes.
And we don't plan to purchase that white eyeliner anytime soon until we need a white eyeliner.
Yeah, especially until we have the funds to just buy it. So a long time ago,
before it came out.
Yeah, before it even came out, before it was even launched. So that's probably about a year ago. I was doing some swatches on that comment is probably still there,
yeah,
on Instagram.
Actually.
And she was such a sweetheart, the girl who left the comment. She was a doll. But I was comparing the NYX white liner and Inglot white liner and the Lime Crime Milk liner. I think it's called Milk. No, it's not. It's Lunar Z. I don't know. It's the white eyeliner. I was comparing liners. And so somebody had commented and said, oh, the Neruda is coming out. And I'm like, well, I don't have that eyeliner. It hasn't even launched yet. And she's like, well, what about that eyeliner? I'm like, I don't have it to swatch to compare. If I had it to swatch to compare, then it would be in the swatch photo. But she kept insisting on the Naruto eyeliner. And after a while, I just had to laugh at it because I don't have it. It's not launched. It's not out yet. There's nothing I can do. I can't swatch it. And I still don't have, you know, the money to just buy it.
Yeah, we still don't have it. But it's like the best eyeliner. We know it's the best eyeliner. And it's the only makeup product that we ever need. Yes. So we just talk about Naruto eyeliner like it's like the best, the end all be all of all cosmetics. And someday when we buy it, we'll know.
Yes, we'll know that it is the end all. So, but yeah, we hear great things about that eyeliner. It's just, we don't have it yet.
Yeah.
And everyone recommends it to us.
And so we're just like, oh, okay. And it's not that we couldn't just go buy it, but yeah, we have so many white eyeliners already. And
yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Heels or flats? Okay, for Kaylee, flats.
Yeah, I prefer flats just all the way. I wear a lot of heels in like my outfit posts and stuff, but let me tell you a secret. I never wear them, like never.
She takes
like,
them right
I
off.
I take them right off. I take pictures or like if I'm going out like to dinner or whatever and I want to look nice or I'm going to a party, like a Christmas party or whatever, I'll wear them the whole night. But if I'm doing an outfit post,
Oscar,
no.
Though.
No.
Yes.
I am a flats. I would actually go barefoot everywhere if I could.
Yeah.
And I'm going to say flats for her too.
Yes, yes. I do wear a lot of flats.
Although, in high school, she rocked these like platform tennis shoes.
Yeah, I still, all I actually,
the time.
I actually do still have a lot of my platform tennis shoes. I like to wear creepers. They're not quite as comfortable as I wish they would be, but yes, I still absolutely love to rock platform tennis shoes. Like, the bigger, the better.
The bigger, the better. Like,
so, yeah, I really want some from, like, Hot Topic, and there's one that's, like, Why Are You?
Oh, yeah.
That brand.
I like that brand.
They're, like, over $100, and they're so beautiful. Someday, I need to save. I'm gonna save up, and I'm gonna get the Naruto eyeliner, and I'm gonna get the Why Are You platform shoes. So, yes. So, flats, but, like, really high flats.
Yeah. It's hard, actually. Dresses or pants? Actually, no, it's not hard. Fuck pants.
Yeah, dresses.
Dresses.
All the way.
Never pants. But if it were dresses or leggings, it would be difficult.
Dresses. Dresses all the way.
I think probably leggings for me, though.
My hair. Okay, sorry.
Because of the chub rub.
The chub rub.
That chub rub.
Then just leggings with the dress.
Leggings and dresses together. Whatever it is, the answer is no pants.
Yes, no pants.
Ever.
Once you get home, pants gone. Bye-bye pants.
If you were wearing pants to begin with, which is silly when you could be wearing leggings.
Yes. We're actually even wearing pants right now.
Like, legging pants.
Yes. A fresh look at my foot. So, yeah. Dresses. Dresses would be the thing. Favorite animal. Okay.
Are we answering for each other?
Yes. Let's answer for each other.
Okay, well, what if I don't know what my favorite animal is?
I do, though. I do know what your favorite animal is, but it's not really an animal.
Ow.
It's a thing. It's a crustacean. I don't know. What the fuck is a jellyfish?
It's an invertebrate. Yeah, I love jellyfish. I love jellyfish and cuttlefish.
And cats.
Octopuses and cats.
Yes. Octopus and cats and jellyfish.
Yeah, those are my big
favorites.
Three. Oh, and giant squids and anything with tentacles. Actually, I'm just like, I'm all over it. Hey, Julie.
Hi, Julie.
There's another inside joke.
Yes.
I think you like, I don't know what your favorite animal is. A cat?
You don't know what my favorite animals are?
A cat and a narwhal.
A narwhal? I like.
And a wolverine.
I like foxes.
Oh, I knew that. I don't know why I didn't say that.
And cats.
Mm-hmm.
And owls.
I
she
like
knew.
Owls too.
She knew this.
I did know that.
She knew these things.
I
she just
didn't.
Couldn't think of them off the top of her head.
I could have just looked around. And,
right?
Yeah.
Yeah. There's a fox in here somewhere, like up there.
Mm-hmm.
And stuff. Yeah. I like lipstick.
My favorite animal is Naruto eyeliner. Your house is burning. What do you take? People and pets already taken care of.
People and pets already taken care of?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, unfortunately, there's no way in hell I'd be able to get all of my makeup.
Right.
And I have renter's insurance.
So
The first thing I would grab is this. There's this jar that my husband bought, and for Christmas a couple years ago, he wrote down 50 reasons why he loves me, and he cut up each, you know, like he wrote it down on a piece of paper and cut it up and stuff and put it in that little jar. And as somebody who has like a chronic illness, I also suffer from some mental illnesses and I suffer from depression. And so he had made me that little thing. So anytime I'm sad, I can hook out like a little piece of paper and read like why he loves me when I feel sad. And so I would take that.
Mine's also savvy. When my boyfriend and I first started seeing each other again, we were kind of like an unofficial thing for a really long time. And we had known each other before and dated before. So when we first started back up seeing each other, he sewed me by hand with a 1940s sewing machine. A 2 foot high, like 2 foot high, that's not 2 feet, but you get my, like a 2 foot high, giant squid. So, and he had made the pattern himself and it's really beautiful and he's actually going to start selling them on Etsy. So,
cute.
Yeah, I'm excited for that, but that's probably the
thing, you would
the thing I would grab. I don't have runner's insurance too, and I would leave my laptop over that. So.
Yes, we're just happy girls.
Yeah.
Favorite movie? Oh, I don't even know. Like a favorite? There's so many movies.
I know.
I feel like TV shows would be better.
Right. Let's just list. I can list like my top five favorite movies, like probably off the top of my head. The Goonies is number one always. And then every single other one of my top five has the actor Patrick Fugit in it, because I am so crushing on him. So Wrist Cutter's a love story. I really love the movie Saved. I really love. I love White Oleander, and there's another one with him in it. And why can't I think of it? Oh, duh, Almost Famous.
Yes.
So there's my probably very top five, and Patrick.
Yes. I'm trying to think.
Get at me.
For me, I'm pretty sure we were probably supposed to answer these for each other, but
yeah, we've just
whatever. my top five favorite movies would be Robin Hood, the one with
the guy.
God, what is his name? I can't think of his freaking name. Morgan Freeman is in that version of Robin Hood as well. I want to say it's Kevin Costner, but I'm not 100% sure. The next one would be Down to You with Julia Stiles and Freddie Prinze Jr. It's my most favorite movie. I love it. It's such like a realistic romance movie because, spoiler alert, they break up. But then they realize like, oh, you know, yeah, we broke up and things were different and things changed. But eventually they kind of find their way back to each other. And they're like, hey, let's try this again. And it works out.
So, oh, it's me and Kyle.
So it's really sweet. It's just a sweet movie. My next favorite movie would be Disney's Beauty and the Beast. Five movies?
Five? Can you think of two more?
Can I think of two more?
I gave five really easily. Do you have any movies that you like with Patrick Fugit in them?
that one where he dies, but like he doesn't.
Yeah, that's Wrist Cutter's a Love Story.
No, the one with the horse, the horseman.
Oh, that's such a good movie.
That's a good movie. See?
Horseman. That has Dennis Quaid in it.
Yes.
I like also Gone Girl's really good.
Yes, Gone Girl's
so good.
Really, really good.
I just really like this boy.
The Avengers. I really
yeah,
like the Avengers.
Very good.
The first one. Me and her went and saw that, and like we dressed up with like super makeup and stuff like that. It was really, really fun. And for my fifth favorite movie would be Under the Tuscan Sun.
I've not seen that either.
I like dramatic movies. Like really like hardcore dramatic movies where they're like, huh, my soul. Or it makes you cry.
No, yeah. I like Patrick Fugit.
cute. He's definitely
so cute.
Cute.
Look him up. He's so cute.
He's cute.
Oh, maybe I can't think of anything though. Something you drink every day.
Pepsi. That's what I drink every day. Something you drink every day?
Yeah.
What do you drink every day? Water?
I've been really good about water lately, actually. Yeah, we have really bad tap water in where I live. Like, the tap water is awful. Yeah. So I have to buy bottled water. And
yeah, it's, there's really hard water here in Vegas too.
So but I've been drinking water really, really well lately.
That's good.
I'm good about it.
I have not. and as before, I mentioned it was Pepsi. That is my addiction. So next question is, own anything matching?
Yes. Actually, yes, many things. The shirt she's wearing right now, we own matching, but I didn't bring it.
In the last video that we were in together, I'll link it in the description, we were both wearing the exact same shirt. Mm-hmm. So we own tons and tons and tons of matching tops.
Yeah, and clothes too.
And makeup.
And makeup.
Obviously.
The jellyfish skirt.
Yes.
We both have a jellyfish skirt. My boyfriend makes skirts and big tutu skirts in any size that you can possibly imagine. If you're a child or if you're a size 32 or 36, we'll make it for you. So we have some matching jellyfish skirts.
Yes. And that's what's really awesome about like us as best friends is because we have so, like, our tastes are really, really, really similar. So if I'm gonna love it, she's gonna love it.
Yeah, so gifting is really easy.
Yes, so basically I'm buying for myself.
Right.
And usually I have to buy two.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, Kaylee's gonna love that.
And I need to have it.
Yes. So yeah, we have a ton of matching stuff. So, okay. And the last, I'm excited for this one.
The last question, favorite TV show.
Yes.
That's easy for both of us. It's Friends.
It's Friends.
And I'd say besides Friends, my other, like, if, like, like, if I can have several superlatives, Futurama.
Futurama's really good.
I love Futurama and Friends.
Yes.
And that was everything. Those are all the questions.
Yes. We both love Law & Order SVU, though.
Oh, yeah. We love Law & Order SVU, like, a lot.
Yeah. Pretty close on par with Friends.
Right.
Like, as far as, like, our favorite TV shows together. So, it would be that. But I have, like, a massive list
of favorite TV shows as well.
Yes. So, but that is it.
That's everything.
That is
it. Now you know everything about our friendship.
So, that is it for the video, you guys. I really hope you guys like what you saw here today. Please feel free to like, comment, and subscribe. I'd love to have you here for our future videos.
Bye.
Until next time, bye.